Hey everyone. Hi, it's Rita from Miss Rita to the Rescue. Here for Cricut Chat, our daily Cricut program that's always live on Facebook, Monday through Friday, 9 o'clock, and then Saturdays at 7 o'clock. And so we're here for Friday. If you're new to our program, Fridays are 3D Friday. So we're going to be doing a 3D project. I also want to talk about some new images that are available in Design Space that I want to show you. I wanted to let you know, if you're watching this on YouTube, you can come to the Facebook Live every morning at 9 a.m., or you can watch the replay on YouTube. I'm getting more and more people that are seeing my posts on Instagram. And so if they click through an Instagram going to YouTube, then just wanted to notify those people that we do this program live every single day, Monday through Friday, 9 a.m. Eastern Time, and Saturday at 7 p.m. And we are Cricut-based, although we once in a while take a break like we did yesterday. Yesterday we did the chunky knit blankets, so I wanted to check in with you all and see if you decided you wanted to try it. I saw several people in my groups posting their progress, and they're doing just wonderfully. Mine is almost done, but I ended up having kind of a busy afternoon, so I couldn't finish it up. But once you get the hang of it, you can do it in about 2 hours, I think. And so that's cool. Oh, I'm glad. I'm glad that people are ordering and they're working on it and they're just about done. That's fabulous. Okay. So today we're going to be working, cause it's 3D, Friday. We're going to be doing this project. It is a 3D pineapple. It even has the pineapple fronds on the top. And then this really cool paper. I'll tell you where I got this paper from. We're going to put this together. This is from Lori Whitlock. I did post a link to this, and she is having a sale until Saturday, 30% off. I believe I'm not, you know what, now that I'm thinking about it, I don't know that I checked her site to see, shop Lori Whitlock. There we go. Let me just check her site to see how much it is for the regular price before the 30% off. I think it was actually $1.99. Let's type in pineapple. Now, she does have a couple of pineapple boxes, but this is the one. Yes, there it is. It's $1.99, but right now you can get 30% off. So here it is. A pineapple shaped box. She also has a couple of other ones. This one is more boxy, and here is her box card. She has a treat box. So when you do a search, or if you use my link, this is the one that we're doing. It's called the pineapple shaped box. It's $1.99. And when you make your purchase, you just add it to, you have to choose a license. I'm always a personal use person. So I add it there and I proceed to checkout. And then what I can do is down here at the bottom or under payment, you would put in, let me just get there. You would put in continue. I have a 15 cent credit, but I can also put this coupon in here, which it's May 2021. And when you hit apply, it gives me 60 cents off of it. So the ultimate price is $1.39 for this project. And you'd find it going to shop.loriwhitlock.com. Okay. And that's how you do it. Now, when you bring this into Design Space, let me just save this and start off new. So what you would do is after you've made your purchase and download to your computer, you're going to go to your downloads file. Mine happens to be over here, and I have all these downloads here. So there's my download file. And then I'm going to open up Design Space, and I'm going to choose, let me back up so you can see, I'm going to choose upload. Okay. And then I am going to choose upload image and then browse. And from there, it will bring me to my files. If I go to my downloads, I can see what I have in downloads that needs to be brought in. Or I also save my SVGs on a file called Documents. So here they are. I believe mine's under LW Gang. And I can find it by typing in pineapple. Like this. And what do we get? We get the pineapple shaped box SVG. We open it up and we bring it in to Design Space. I've done this twice so that you know. And we're going to insert it into Design Space. And you can see it's a pretty simple project. There are a few things that you need to do on it first. Okay. So you do need to attach the tops and the whole actual pineapple. So this is the top and this is the bottom. Don't miss this part. So we actually close it with a bottom that's a square, and this is the top that actually can come off. Except mine's on there really good. Okay, so it can come off. So I suppose you could give this if you were having like a summer party or something and you wanted to put some like a treat bag. It's more like a treat box, right? Hey, I see Lynn. Lynn, are you out of the hospital? I got your email. I hope you're well. And then it has on it the fronds, which is done like a quilled flower. That's why I kind of wanted to show you this, because it's really kind of fun putting this together, and it would make a nice little party gift if you were having like a luau or a tiki party or something like that to kick off your summer celebrations. And I also have from Lori Whitlock a few new cards. Yay, Lynn, I'm so glad. We'll probably be doing them. They're called shadow box cards, and I just want to point them out to you so that I believe they're called shadow box. Yes. So when you go to cards, if this is something you want to learn how to do. So here is this one. It's a unicorn shadow, which is really cute. And it folds so it goes into a 5x7, but it's got a shadowy look to it. We'll do these next week. And these are called shadow box cards. There's a whole bundle that you can get that has six of them. Now, their price is $13.45, but with the coupon, you'll get 30% off, and you get six really adorable summertime shadow box cards, including a patriotic one, a couple of like aloha type things, you know, like beach, even the swimsuits on a line, which I think is absolutely adorable. And then, of course, unicorns. So that might be something you want to think about buying. You can buy these individually or buy them all together. That's up to you. So this is what we do when we upload a file to Design Space. And it's a very simple thing. I like the top being the same color as the body. So I will go in and do color sync. Let's just go over here so you can kind of see. So over here, you know, we're looking at layers, but if you want to use color sync, it's really a good way to make sure all the colors are synced. That's why it's called color sync, I guess. So when you hit color sync, it shows you the colors that everything is in, okay? And you will see here we've got a dark yellow, and that's for the main body, and that's for the bottom. But I want to take on the lighter yellow, I want to take this piece, the one that has the dash cut lines, that's the top piece, and I want to move it to the body because I want to cut these things out in patterned paper because I think this looks really fun in patterned paper. It's kind of like getting a whole fruit bowl, and I did find some Fruitalicious paper. I'm going to show you where I got that from in a sec. So here we go. There's three colors now, and make sure that you are attaching all of the pieces, and then you can cut them on your machine. This, by the way, if you have a Joy, probably would not cut on the Joy too well because this piece here, the green piece, is really wide. You could make it smaller, but you'd end up with a much, much smaller project pineapple. Okay. So, I cut this out using my maker, and big news is that I've got my new maker, on the way today. So that's pretty cool. Now, before we get started putting this together, I do want to show you some brand new images in Cricut Design Space that are cutie related. And thank you to Abigail, another fellow product expert who pointed them out to us all. Cricut Cuties, I want to go here to show you. There's a brand new grouping of Cricut Cuties that I have put into three separate files. So there's the Drawn Cuties, and there's also, let me see, how do I get out of here? There's also Print Then Cut Cuties, and then they have like a regular cutie. Let's just show you. We're going to replace that. So we're going to show you, we're going to go to images. You can either come and get my files for these, or you can go and do them yourself. It's up to you, whatever you want to do. So here we are going to image sets. And if you type in the word cutie, you will see there's a couple of like cutie related image sets that are not actual Cricut Cuties, but there are actually three. Yes, three. So you've got, this is our original Cricut Cuties, the one that has the angry guy in there. Then there's the newer, Cricut Cutie cartoons, which are really cute. And then this is the new one. It's called We Love Cricut Cutie. And you will see that, it comes in, each of the cuties come in different styles. So for example, this here one, this jumping Cricut Cutie is for a print and cut file. So if you want to make stickers, you could use this to make your stickers with Print Then Cut. There's also here for people who are, maybe they don't want to use Print Then Cut, they want to use their pens. They're drawn like this. And then you'll also see them in just a basic cut or the inverse of the basic cut. So what do you use those for? This one here, if you wanted to cut it with maybe you'd want to do black vinyl, and you could also put on the back of it. I'll bring these in here. So there's a couple of things that you can do. Foiled cuties. Yes, absolutely. You could foil them. So this one here, I think is meant for vinyl, because if you cut it out all in green and then put it on your, I think I might do that. Put it on my car. Maybe not this one with the chin, but maybe like a happy one, but I cut it out in green vinyl and put it on my car. That'd be fun. This one here, you would probably cut out in maybe a black outline, or what you could do is you can duplicate it and contour a back. So here it is. I can hide all contours and come here. So here's my back, and I could change the color to green. And then I just arrange this, send it to the front, and all of a sudden I have a two-color image. And I could cut this out in vinyl, and then you'd have the outlines instead of doing this. Let's change this to green too. So there are two ways to sort of do this. If you wanted to do a double, like a two-layer image, or if you just wanted to cut out this as a single-layer image, there you go. All right. So there are a ton of these images. Again, let's just go back. It's called We Love Cricut Cuties with the exclamation point. There's 64 images. They are repeated. I think they're almost all of them are repeated at least three times. Some of them are draw. Some of them are cut. Some of them are print then cut. So there's everything. Some of the cuties are holding joys. Some are holding explorers. And the other one is holding over here, the maker, and then there's the explorer. So depending on what kind of cutie you want, there you go. And there's some that are angry. Maybe they couldn't get their mat clean enough or something, and then there are happy ones. There's even one dreaming of a land full of just crickets or something like that. Anyway, so there is that. So let's put this now together. No, I don't know. I think they're kind of charming. I think the cuties are kind of charming. But anyway, after the video, someone saying they don't think their husband will want a cutie. I love the light bulb one. Do you ever have those Cricut light bulb moments? I do all the time. And so I like that one. I don't like the angry ones because I think we can always work through those things. So let us put together this fun project. We're going to go down here to my workspace and show you how to put this together. So as I mentioned, I did this in paper. This is the paper that I used. Let me show you the pad. I actually got this at Joann's. It's a Park Lane paper. So it's a little change from my normal paper procurement place. Ooh, it's called Rainbow Love, and it's a very small stack, but it is 12 by 12. So you can see here, it's very pretty. I actually think, and there's the fruit salad one. I think I actually bought this for $5. It has rainbows, flowers, and some nice polka dots and everything. So I got this at Joann. It's Park Lane Rainbow Love, and it's retails for $12.99, but it was on sale, so I think I got it for like $5, or maybe it was $5.99, about half or something. So the way that it comes out when we cut this is that there is one main body piece, and then you have this, which is the bottom, and this, which is the top. Then you can cut out all of these pieces to put on the pineapple. And then you have this, which is the fronds on the top of the crown of the pineapple. I think it's called a crown. So we are going to roll that up and put it on the top here. So let's get started on the main body first. And so let's put these two pieces aside with the crown. And you'll see that this has a lot of dashed cut lines, and we're just going to fold at all of them. This is how we get 3D. It's a lot of tabs, a lot of tabs. So make sure you're going through and unfolding and training all of those tabs so that it will be easy to put together. Now the top tab, the very, very top tabs are actually going to go the opposite way. They're going to be like a mountain. Everything else is going to be a valley. So just so that you know, because that tripped me up the first time, but it will not trip me up the second time. So here we go. So it's going to make a square shape. And then at the top, these things are going to be up so we can put the actual cover of it on. So still go through. There's a lot of dash cut lines on this. And remember, when you buy from Laurie Whitlock, you can use her solid. She has something called solid score lines. And we did that last week where we replaced the solid. They're actually called solid lines. They come in as a cut line, but you turn them into scoring. So if you want to use your scoring wheel or your scoring stylus, you do need to make sure that you transfer those solid lines to scoring, okay? Otherwise, you're going to end up with a very piecemeal kind of project. Okay, so once you've got all of those done, all of these, all of this, I saw one that I didn't do. So once you've got the whole thing sort of folded and everything, we're going to fold it in half. And we're going to use this side tab right here. And we're going to glue that together. That's what's going to make this flat project into a 3D project. And while we have it flat, we're going to take our pieces. We've got a lot of little pieces here. And we are simply going to attach them. Now you'll see here, let me see if I can show you. Okay, so this here is a part of the bottom, and in actuality, it's this. This is was supposed to be a bottom, but I cut it out. I cut out two, so just so that you know. But then you've got all of these pieces, and we're going to glue them on, and then they have these top pieces. Now, if you wanted to get fancy, if on this double-sided paper, you could make the bulk of it this and then flip it over. But I think I'm going to go for continuity on this and just put these here. Then I'll flip it over and add them all to the outside of our pineapple and before we actually make it 3D. Okay, so we are just gluing these pieces. You guys are going to be more precise about this than I am, and because you have more time to do it on. So we're just putting these glued pieces in there. And it's best to do this flat. When I first started doing this, I would put them together and then put the pieces on. And what I found was it was a lot harder to get the pieces to stay put, especially on a 3D piece, because I was trying to, you know, get them to stay on. And I was always like kind of trying to finagle around and everything. So all of a sudden my glue doesn't want to come out. Okay. So once you get the first side done, flip it over, do the same thing with the back side. And really there is no front and back side to this project. So it's the same on both sides, just so that you know. And this is not a square, it's a rectangle. It's a squared off rectangle. So it does only go one way. You can't put it this way, okay? Also a mistake I made at the beginning. Okay, almost done with this. I do need to use my pen because for some reason this feels a little blocked. And I bent my pen. Not a good thing, Rita. Okay, there we go. All right, so we're going to put the glue here. and it's starting to feel a lot like the early part of the summer, which I love. Although yesterday I had somebody came to my friend comes to mow the lawn, and I had the window open, and darn it all, I had a terrible like allergic reaction to, because he was mowing the lawn for the first time for the season. I don't know if there was just like a lot of pollen in it or whatever, but it wafted its way through to the house, and I ended up having a terrible allergic headache, and I ended up having to take Benadryl and lie down in the afternoon. I hate doing that, but you know, sometimes you just gotta do. I should have closed that window. Wow, why is this coming out so much? I squeezed it too hard. Hey, listen, while I'm doing this, make sure you're not squeezing your glue too hard. Less is more when it comes to glue. If you want to know what kind of glue, this is the kind of glue that I've been using almost exclusively for maybe it's about 8 or 9 months now. I really, really love it. It's called Barely Art Precision Craft Glue. You can buy it through Amazon. The other one is called Art Glitter Glue, which I also like, but I like the tips on these ones, and I think the price is right, and it's easy accessibility too. So you can look for the link on my description after I finish the video. Okay, so here we go. This now opens up as a box, and you'll notice that the top and the bottom are slightly different. The top here has these flaps or these folds. Okay. And what we're going to do is we're going to do the bottom first. So the bottom's pretty easy. We're just going to put the glue on these side folds. And when you're doing that, you do need to make sure with this project, you need to make sure that you're really squared off. So you don't want it to be like this or over. You really want that edge to meet with that dotted cut line or your score line, whichever you do. And that is so that A, your pineapple will stand up, but also B, that the cover goes on, and the cover does get a little bit tough to deal with if you don't have it squared off on both the bottom and on the top, because square is square, right? All right, so that's what we're doing here. And again, you will do this better than me because you'll take the time, but I'm just showing you the mechanics of it. And so you can go ahead and do it on your own. That's what I do. And yesterday I actually asked Dawn because I thought she saw it, but there were like 3 people that came to watch the video that weren't happy with the way that I chit chat. And I thought about it and I thought, you know, this has happened before with YouTube. And the thing is, it's called Cricut Chat, and that's what you guys like. If you didn't like the chatting, and I consistently got that feedback, then I would stop doing it and just give you the tutorial. But I like to chat, and I think you guys like it too. So what if some people don't like it? They can go someplace else and learn, right? So, oh well. You know, I don't care. I really don't care because I know there are people out there that really do like it. So, okay. So here's the bottom, and then the tabs are going to be, we're going to be pushed in. We're going to put a little bit of glue on each of the tabs. Just like that. Hi, Penny. And we're going to put the bottom on there. Now, be careful to make sure that the bottom is placed well on there, nice and squared off, okay? And it's the bottom, so it doesn't have any like decoration on there. I mean, you could certainly make a decoration, but you don't need to. Okay, so once that's really in there, we can then come up to the top. The top goes together the same way, where the tabs are going to go on the inside. But then when we start closing this off, the tabs going in like this, they're going to actually stand up. That's going to give us kind of like the edge or the lip to put the box top on. So, man, I'm using a lot of glue today. Don't know why, but there you go. I was up super early because I went to bed early yesterday because it wasn't my allergy thing. It was the Benadryl. I took Benadryl, and then I was like, why am I so sleepy? And I'm like, duh, you know, because I probably took a little too much. Instead of one pill, I took two. And so I was really, really sleepy. So I was up with the birds this morning and saw a beautiful cardinal. And you can hear him sometimes. I have a beautiful cardinal that comes to visit. And I don't know what that is. That's not a cardinal, but we have some nice birds. I don't feed the birds because my cat, and in the past, my cats hunt. They would go outside and they just go out briefly. They don't really wander or anything. And the only cat I have now is Frankie, but they would go out and sort of wander around and catch things. And they have caught a lot of baby bunnies, which is heartbreaking. Sometimes they've caught birds, and sometimes, you know, they're cats. That's what they do, you know? So now that I have glued here, and remember we glued down here from the bottom, this is where it gets a little tiny bit tricky. There are these little teeny tiny tabs, only four of them, and we're going to take and glue them to this side next, where they lay next to it, and we're going to make sure that this part is going to stand up like this. There we go. And we're going to move around here and do all four of those so that we have a place for the top to go on and for the green crown to go on. You might have to finagle a little bit here just until they caught up. So you see that? It's closing up the box like this. Okay, and do try, as I did on the bottom, to try to keep it as square as possible, because then the next piece, which is the top, the very top, it is the cover to the box. So this would make a very cute, like, treat box for, I don't know, end of summer people or something like that. And so we're going to fold at all four corners, and then you have these tabs here. So we're going to just take and glue these tabs. And you can do them inside or outside. I prefer to do them in. And just give it a second for it to catch. Now, tomorrow is Saturday night. We have our date night, and I decided yesterday that we would do a project with alcohol ink, since I did get a whole new bunch of alcohol inks in. It is going to be a like... a tile that we're going to alcohol ink and then embellish with a cutout in vinyl. Okay, so get your alcohol inks ready if you have them, or if you don't have them, you just kind of want to know what's going on, then just come along. And we're always happy to have you. So when this is glued, we are then going to put it onto the top of our pineapple. And that's why I was so insistent about squaring it off, because it's a snug fit, okay? And if you don't square it off, then you could have one of these, and like I am right here, having one of these sort of bow in. And so I think that might be due to the glue not being 100% dry. Okay, so then your pineapple is done, but a pineapple needs fronds. And so here we go. I'm going to reach over and get some tweezers, though. Where are my tweezers? Okay, so here are my tweezers. You can also use a quilling tool for this, but a lot of people don't have them. I do, but I'll show you how to do it with the tweezers. So this is cut out. It's really fun. It looks a lot like the rolled flowers, which we haven't yet covered, and I wanted to know if you wanted to do some rolled flowers. I see a lot of people in the groups making things like shadow boxes with the rolled flowers. So let me know if that's something you want to do, and we will certainly cover it. There are a lot of rolled flowers out there, both in Design Space and in like from other designers. So you're not just limited to the ones in Cricut. You can buy others going outside. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to take the quilling tool right here, and this is a tweezer. It's one of those always closed tweezers. So I'm just going to grab the outside edge, just like this, and I'm going to start to roll like this, just like this. I'm just rolling along. Now guide it with your fingers a little bit, and don't worry about what's going to happen with the leaves themselves until you get done, okay? So we're just going to roll it, and this until you get used to it. Feels a little awkward, so, you know, you can always just take it out and do it again if you want. So don't feel like you need to be good at this at the very beginning. And I like to condition the paper a little bit so that it will easily roll. And when I say condition the paper, I just mean like just using my fingers to kind of give it a little more, I don't know, wiggle room to make it more pliable, I guess. So when you get to the end, right here, you'll have this tab. So you're going to take out your tweezers. And this looks a little bit different, but see the bottom? There's all that rolled piece there. And I'm going to let it out a little tiny bit because I don't want my fronds to be too tightly wound. All right. So here we go. Now, the inside piece, I'm going to use my little tweezers and do this. Okay, so it should be sort of flat here. And then what we're going to do is put glue on here and attach it here. Now, if you want, you can use a glue gun, a hot glue, if you want for this part. I forgot to heat mine up, so I'm just going to use regular glue, but I need to hold on to it. So see what I did? I put it on the bottom, and now I'm going to fluff. You guys know I love to fluff, so here it is. But what I'm doing is I'm holding the bottom piece to that rolled piece bottom, and just want to give it a little bit of time to let that glue catch. And then I'm going to sort of fluff out these. Not a whole lot, but enough that it resembles a pineapple. You know how they are sort of slightly bent? So here's what I'm doing. I'm fluffing while I'm holding. I'm fluffing with one hand while I'm holding on the other. I think the top ones could go either way. And then there are ones down at the bottom that I kind of just left. You can use, by the way, you can use whatever, your tool or something like that to sort of hold it on there. And I suppose if I had remembered, I would use hot glue for this. When I do my rolled flowers, I always use hot glue, but I didn't think of it this morning. Actually, I had a morning meeting, so I was kind of distracted. So here we go. You know, and this is one of those, you get better at it as you progress, as you try it and do it more times. You could hold it like this if you wanted to, that sort of thing. I'm just trying to get it to stick. And it seems like it's almost done. It's taking. Okay. And I'm going to actually take the cover off of my pineapple. And this is where I'm going to put the pineapple frond, or the crown is at the top here. So that way it can be drying on their glue. Just put it in the middle. Can be drying in both places. All right. And this takes a little finagling. You guys will be more patient than I am, but it's going to catch. Again, glue guns would be fine here and actually welcomed. And that, friends, once this actually takes, is the end of our project. So quick, right? Super quick. And we just need to wait for it to glue. And you can make this any way you like. I've seen this with polka dots. I loved this paper because it had, where are they? So it had pineapples on it. So it's kind of like a fruit salad sort of thing. I think this would be really fun if you had like an outdoor event and you could put rice on the inside so that they won't fall over with the breeze, you know, that kind of thing. I think that would be a lot of fun. And it's just really a cute thing. And it's all sort of self-contained. So there's not like a bunch of pieces that you have to, wouldn't it be nice to give to some people in a shut-ins or something like that, just to sort of signal that summertime is coming. And then once it's done, then you're just going to put this right on top here. And that's it. Now, mine's not 100% done with that. So let me just recap. Go back here. Remember, we're getting, this file came from Laurie Whitlock. It is a paid file, but it's going to cost you about less than $1.50. You go to her site, which is shop.lauriewhitlock.com, and you can use the search bar and type in pineapple, and you will find, this is the actual product that we did. It's called a pineapple shaped box. It's $1.99. And then make sure you use her code, which is May, M-A-Y, 2021, all in uppercase, and you can get your 30% off. And then you're going to bring it into Design Space. So that's that. And then in terms of the cuties, remember you can go to image sets right here, image sets. This is in the search engine, image sets, and you type in the word cutie or Cricut or whatever you want, because this is called We Love Cricut Cutie. And you'll see 64 new images. Some of them are for print and cut, some of them are for drawing, and some of them are for cutting, whether you're doing it with vinyl or paper. So that is just something that one of the product experts brought up, and I wanted to make sure that I told you. What is this? give him a kiss. Thank you. All right. So that is it for today. I'm so glad that you came. And please, if you have time, can make it for a date night. I'm inviting you to date night on Saturday night. And then just a couple other reminders. One is we still have our joy giveaway going on. And you can put your name in for that every single day. I'll put the link in the description of the video. And I think that's it. And then we will make the announcement next Saturday. So do that this week. You can put your name in every single day, but you just have to like or forward or comment on any one of my videos. And there's literally dozens and dozens of videos so you can watch. And that's going to help us get better audiences. And I appreciate you doing that. And that's why I'm giving away a nice Cricut Joy with all the extras that you're going to need. So that's it for today, everyone. I hope you have a wonderful day. We'll see you again tomorrow night, God willing. And I hope you get some crafting in today. Take care.